we now start module 3 of chapter 9. The title of this module is Bilinear Transformation Normal Form. We recall that a transformation of the form W equal to Fz equal to Az plus B by Cz plus D, where A, B, C, D are complex constants and AD minus BC not equal to 0 is called a bilinear transformation. This module has three main objectives. One is fixed point or invariant point. Another is normal form or canonical form of a bilinear transformation. And last one is cross ratio. If W equal to Fz is a transformation, then the solution of the equation Fz minus Z equal to 0 is called fixed point of that transformation. We show that a bilinear transformation has at most two fixed points, and in some special circumstance it has only one fixed point. So depending upon the number of fixed point, a bilinear transformation can be classified into different types, such as parabolic type, elliptic type, hyperbolic type, etc. And in that case, a bilinear transformation can be put in special form, which is known as normal form or canonical form of a bilinear transformation. After that, we introduce the concept of cross ratio of four complex numbers, and we show that a bilinear transformation leaves a cross ratio invariant. We also provide some example relating to this module. We now start our presentation. So we start bilinear transformation normal form. First, we define fixed point or invariant points, the points which coincide with its transformation are called fixed or invariant points of the transformation. If Z is a fixed point of the transformation T, then Tz equal to Z. The identity transformation Iz equal to Z has every Z in extended complex plane as its fixed points. The fixed points of the transformation W equal to Z square are solutions of Z square equal to Z, that is Z equal to 0 and 1. So a result proves that in general there are two values of Z for which W equal to Z. But there is only one if A minus D square plus 4BC equal to 0. So also that if there are distinct invariant points P and Q, then the transformation can be written in the form W minus P by W minus Q equal to K into Z minus P by Z minus Q. And that if there is only one invariant point P, the transformation can be written in the form 1 by W minus P equal to K plus 1 by Z minus P, where K is a constant. So proof, let W equal to Az plus B by Cz plus D, Ad minus BC not equal to 0, be a bilinear transformation. For fixed points, we have W equal to Z, that is Cz square minus A minus D into Z minus B equal to 0. In general, this equation has two values of z and hence two fixed points. If the discriminant, that is a minus d whole square plus 4bc equal to 0, then there is only one fixed point. Let p and q be two fixed points of the transformation w equal to az plus b by cz plus d. Then from equation number 4, we obtain cp square minus ap equal to b minus dp and cq square minus aq equal to b minus dq. Now, w minus p, this is equal to az plus b by cz plus d minus p, and this gives after simplification a minus cp into z minus p by cz plus d. Similarly, we obtain w minus q equal to a minus cq into z minus q by cz plus d. Therefore, w minus p by w minus q is equal to a minus cp into z minus p by a minus cq into z minus q, that is equal to k into z minus p by z minus q, where k equal to a minus cp by a minus cq. So, if there is only one fixed point, then we have p equal to q, that is equal to, we can write p plus q by 2, and that is by equation 4 a minus d by 2c. Therefore, 1 by w minus p equal to cz plus d by a minus cp into z minus p. Now, we replace value of d from this equation, and then simplifying, we obtain 1 by w minus p equal to k plus 1 by z minus p, where k equal to c by a minus cp. So, this proves the theorem. So, remark, equations 1 and 2 are known as the normal form or canonical form of a bilinear transformation. A bilinear transformation w equal to fz with more than two fixed points in extended complex plane must be the identity transformation. So, note, a bilinear transformation having only one fixed point is called a parabolic transformation. And if the fixed point is p, then the transformation is of the form 1 by w minus p equal to k plus 1 by z minus p, where k is a constant. A bilinear transformation having two fixed points p and q can be written in the form w minus p by w minus q equal to k into z minus p by z minus q, where k is a constant. If mod k equal to 1, but k not equal to 1, then it is called elliptic transformation. On the other hand, if k greater than 0 is real, then it is called hyperbolic transformation. A bilinear transformation which is neither parabolic nor elliptic nor hyperbolic is called loxodromic. That is, in that case, it has two fixed points and satisfies the condition k equal to a into e to the power I alpha, where a not equal to 1 and alpha not equal to 0. So, now we consider an example. Find all the bilinear transformations which have fixed points 1 and minus 1. So, we assume that w equal to fz equal to az plus b by cz plus d, where ad minus bc not equal to 0 is the require bilinear transformation. Given that 1 and minus 1 are two fixed points of this transformation, that means f 1 equal to 1 and f minus 1 equal to minus 1. Now, f 1 equal to 1 implies a plus b equal to c plus d, and f minus 1 equal to minus 1 implies a minus b equal to d minus c. So, solving these two relation, we obtain a equal to d and b equal to c. Therefore, the required transformation is w equal to fz equal to az plus b by bz plus a, where a square minus b square is not 0. So, another example, find the normal form of the bilinear transformation w equal to 3iz plus 1 by z plus I. So, for fixed points of this transformation, we have w equal to z, that is z equal to 3iz plus 1 by z plus I. This gives z square minus 2iz minus 1 equal to 0, that is z minus I square equal to 0, that is z equal to I. That means this transformation has only one fixed point. So, its normal form is 1 by w minus I equal to 1 by z minus I plus k, where k is a constant, and this is obviously parabolic transformation. So, another example, find the bilinear transformation with fixed points minus 1 and 1 carrying the point z equal to I onto w equal to minus I. So, since this transformation has two fixed points minus 1 and 1, its normal form is w plus 1 by w minus 1 equal to k into z plus 1 by z minus 1, where k is some constant. Given that this transformation maps z equal to I onto w equal to minus I. So, from this we obtain minus I plus 1 by minus I minus 1 equal to k into I plus 1 by I minus 1. And solving, we obtain k equal to minus 1. Therefore, the required transformation is w plus 1 by w minus 1 equal to minus z plus 1 by z minus 1. And simplifying, we obtain w equal to 1 by z. So far, we have discussed about fixed point and normal form of a bilinear transformation. We see that a bilinear transformation has at most two fixed points. If it has two fixed points P and Q, then it can be written in the form W minus P by W minus Q equal to K into Z minus P by Z minus Q, where K is a constant. Depending upon the value of K, it can be classified as elliptic type or hyperbolic type or loxodromic type. On the other hand, if the bilinear transformation has only one fixed point, then it is called parabolic transformation, and it can be written in the form 1 by w minus p equal to k plus 1 by z minus p, where k is any constant. We also note that if a bilinear transformation has more than two fixed points, then it is an identity transformation. Now, we introduce the concept of cross ratio of four distinct complex numbers. We show that a bilinear transformation leaves a cross ratio invariant That means if Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 is any four complex numbers in the extended complex plane, and if W1, W2, W3, W4 are the images of that points, then the cross ratio of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 is equal to the cross ratio of W1, W2, W3 and W4. We also show that if Z1, Z2, Z3 is any three complex number in the extended Z plane, and if W1, W2, W3 are three complex number in the extended W plane, then there exist a unique bilinear transformation W equal to Fz such that Fzk equal to Wk for k equal to 1, 2, 3. Now we go to our presentation. We now develop the specific bilinear transformation which maps three distinct points in the extended Z plane onto three distinct points in the extended W plane. For that, we first introduce the concept of cross ratio. For three distinct complex numbers Z1, Z2, Z3 in extended complex plane, the cross ratio of four points Z1, Z2, Z3 is defined as Z1, Z2, Z3 equal to Z minus Z1 into Z2 minus Z3 by Z1 minus Z2 into Z3 minus Z. If one of the numbers is replaced by infinity, say Z3, then the cross ratio of Z1, Z2 and infinity equal to limit Z3 tends to infinity Z minus Z1 into Z2 by Z3 minus 1 by Z1 minus Z2 into 1 minus Z by Z3. That is equal to minus of Z minus Z1 by Z1 minus Z2. So note, the cross ratio will change if the order of the factors is changed. Since four letters Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 can be arranged in factorial 4, that is 24 ways, there will be 24 cross ratios. But as a matter of fact, there will be only 6 distinct cross ratios. And the 6 distinct cross ratios are cross ratio of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, Z1, Z2, Z4, Z3, Z1, Z3, Z2, Z4, Z1, Z3, Z4, Z2, Z1, Z4, Z2, Z3 and Z1, Z4, Z3, Z2. So now we prove a result: a bilinear transformation leaves a cross ratio invariant. So let W equal to Az plus B by Cz plus D, AD minus BC not equal to 0, be a bilinear transformation. Let W1, W2, W3, W4 be the images of the points Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 respectively under the transformation 1. To prove the theorem, we have to show that W1, W2, W3, W4 equal to cross ratio of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. We have cross ratio of W1, W2, W3, W4 equal to W1 minus W2 into W3 minus W4 by W2 minus W3 into W4 minus W1. Now, W1 minus W2 equal to AZ1 plus B by CZ1 plus D minus AZ2 plus B by CZ2 plus D. And simplifying, we get AD minus BC into Z1 minus Z2 by CZ1 plus D into CZ2 plus D. Similarly, W2 minus W3 equal to AD minus BC into Z2 minus Z3 by CZ2 plus D into CZ3 plus D. W3 minus W4 equal to AD minus BC into Z3 minus Z4 by CZ3 plus D into CZ4 plus D. And W4 minus W1 equal to AD minus BC into Z4 minus Z1 by CZ4 plus D into CZ1 plus D. Therefore, we obtain cross ratio of W1, W2, W3, W4 is equal to Z1 minus Z2 into Z3 minus Z4 by Z2 minus Z3 into Z4 minus Z1, and which is equal to the cross ratio of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. So, this proves the theorem. Now, another result, given three distinct points Z1, Z2 and Z3 in the extended Z plane and three distinct points W1, W2 and W3 in the extended W plane, there exists a unique bilinear transformation W equal to Fz such that Fzk equal to Wk for k equal to 1, 2 and 3. So, proof, we assume that none of the 6 points is infinity. Let W equal to Fz equal to Az plus B by Cz plus D, where Ad minus BC not equal to 0 be the bilinear transformation. We wish to solve for A, B, C and D in terms of Z1, Z2, Z3, W1, W2 and W3. For k equal to 1 to 3, we have W minus Wk equal to Az plus B by Cz plus D minus Azk plus B by Czk plus D, and which gives after simplification Ad minus Bc into Z minus Zk by Cz plus D into Czk plus D. So, from 6, we obtain W minus W1 by W minus W3 equal to Cz3 plus D by Cz1 plus D into Z minus Z1 by Z minus Z3. Replacing Z by Z2 and W by W2 in equation number 7, we obtain W2 minus W3 by W2 minus W1 equal to Cz1 plus D by Cz3 plus D into Z2 minus Z3 by Z2 minus Z1. So, multiplying 7 and 8, we obtain W minus W1 into W2 minus W3 by W minus W3 into W2 minus W1 equal to Z minus Z1 into Z2 minus Z3 by Z minus Z3 into Z2 minus Z1. So, solving for W in terms of Z and the 6 points gives the desired transformation. Now, we assume that one of the points, say Z3, equal to infinity. Then, equation 9 would be modified by taking the limit as Z3 tends to infinity. In this case, we would have W minus W1 into W2 minus W3 by W minus W3 into W2 minus W1 equal to Z minus Z1 by Z2 minus Z1. Now we suppose that fz and gz are both bilinear transformations that agree at 3 or more points in the extended complex plane. Therefore, wk equal to f of zk equal to g of zk for k equal to 1, 2, 3. Thus, for k equal to 1, 2, 3, we obtain f inverse compos g of zk equal to f inverse of g of zk, that is equal to f inverse of wk, which is equal to zk. And so, by remark 2, f inverse compos g equal to I, that is identity transformation. This gives f equal to g, which proves the uniqueness part of this theorem. So, now we consider example. Find a bilinear transformation that maps the points z equal to I 2 and minus 2 onto w equal to I 1 and minus 1 respectively. So, solution, we know that the transformation which maps the points z 1, z 2 and z 3 in the extended z plane onto the points w 1, w 2 and w 3 in the extended w plane is w minus w 1 into w 2 minus w 3 by w minus w 3 into w 2 minus w 1 equal to z minus z 1 into z 2 minus z 3 by z minus z 3 into z 2 minus z 1. So, here z 1 equal to I, z 2 equal to 2, z 3 equal to minus 2, w 1 equal to I, w 2 equal to 1 and w 3 equal to minus 1. Therefore, from above we obtain w minus I into 1 plus 1 by w plus 1 into 1 minus I equal to z minus I into 2 plus 2 by z plus 2 into 2 minus I. Simplifying, we obtain w equal to 3z plus 2i by iz plus 6, which is the required bilinear transformation. So, another example, let fz be a bilinear transformation such that f of infinity equal to 1, f of I equal to I and f of minus I equal to minus I. Find the image of the unit disk, that is set of points z belongs to C such that mod z less than 1 under the transformation fz. So, solution, let w equal to az plus b by cz plus d, where ad minus bc not equal to 0 be the required bilinear transformation. Now, f of infinity equal to 1. This implies a by c equal to 1, that is a equal to c. F of I equal to I, that means ai plus b by ci plus d equal to I, that is a minus d into I plus b plus c equal to 0. Also, f of minus I equal to minus I gives minus ai plus b by minus ci plus d equal to minus I, that is a minus d into I minus b plus c equal to 0. So, solving equation number 10, 11 and 12, we obtain a equal to c equal to d equal to minus b. Therefore, w equal to fz equal to z minus 1 by z plus 1 is the required bilinear transformation. Now, putting z equal to r e to the power I theta, we see that w equal to r e to the power I theta minus 1 by r e to the power I theta plus 1. That is equal to r cos theta minus 1 plus I r sin theta by r cos theta plus 1 plus I r sin theta. And simplifying, we obtain r square minus 1 by r square plus 2 r cos theta plus 1 plus I into 2 r by r square plus 2 r cos theta plus 1. The map of a point lying on merged equal to 1 lies on the imaginary axis in the W plane, because for r equal to 1, real part of W equal to 0. If r less than, then we see that real W less than 0. That is, the image of a point lying inside the unit circle merged equal to 1 lies in the left half of the W plane. From this module, we came to know about fixed point or invariant point of a bilinear transformation, its normal form. We also came to know about cross ratio, and we see that a bilinear transformation leaves a cross ratio invariant. We also note that if z1, z2, z3 are three distinct complex numbers in the extended z plane, and w1, w2, w3 are three complex numbers in the extended W plane, then there exists a unique bilinear transformation W equal to fz such that wk equal to f of zk for k equal to 1, 2, 3. We also discuss some example relating to this module. For more problem, please see the self-assessment part and also some reference books. This ends module 3 of chapter 9.